When learning data science, what should I focus on? That's a question I've been getting a lot of lately, and so I thought I'd make a recording with my perspective and my answer on that. My answer right now, it's 2018. This is what I'm starting to tell people. Instead of choosing a language that you need to focus on or choosing a specific product, I'm telling people, start focusing and thinking about real-time analytics. And here is why I say that. I say that because I think everyone's mindset and their decision-making isn't quite ready for real-time analytics. And so I want to explain a little bit of a story about what it's like when you start building a real-time analytics product for a customer. It goes usually something like this. You build them some dashboards and you convince them that real-time is what they want to do. And you build them and create this real-time dashboard for them. And it usually is a ticker, kind of looks like a stock. Like if you track stocks, there's a ticker symbol, but in real-time, whatever it is they're tracking, whether it's sales or, you know, some sensor data, you get a real-time, you know, dashboard that ticks along and people get really excited about it because now they can see their data in real-time. And instead of looking at last week or last month's data, now they start to see it in real time and they get really excited. And then here's the point where things get a little tricky. When you start to talk about, now that you can see this real time data, are you gonna sit there and watch this all the time? And almost everyone's answer is no, I don't have time to sit and watch, you know, a ticker move up and down all the time, which makes sense. People don't have that time to do that. So then you start getting to, well, what actions are you going to take off this real-time data? And here's one of the things that people commonly say. Well, when we see a big spike or a big drop, we're going to call a meeting. And when you start digging into who are they going to call a meeting with, well, it's the VP of this and the director of that. And before you know it, you have a meeting with a lot of people that have very busy schedules, and that meeting might not happen for a couple of days. And so in the real-time space, you just had a drop and it takes you 2 days to get that meeting set up. That's too long. That worked when you got a report from last week or last month's data. But if you're talking about real-time data, you need to know how you're gonna act on that data right away. So your decisions and your actions need to be automated. And so that's why I keep telling people to start focusing on real-time analytics, and the decisions that you need to make need to be really quick and they need to be known ahead of time. You need to know when there's a large drop in your real-time analytics, you need to know what your action is. Like, what are you gonna do? And preferably, is there something that I can just automate so that a human doesn't even have to get involved? But that's the thing I start telling people about when they want to learn real-time analytics. So start spending some time, figure out what tools are out there available for real-time analytics. How does that differ? What kind of, you know, products and processes are available so that you can ingest all that data coming in real time? Because it's a little bit different than your traditional just throw everything into a SQL database. So that's why I'm pretty big on how do you focus and what should you learn if you want to get started in data science. And I keep telling people, start focusing on real-time analytics. And I also think not a lot of companies are there today, but I think 4 or 5 years down the road, I think this is going to be a part of every business decision and every business all over the place. And I don't know that schools or even corporate training is properly preparing people for the mindset shift from we have last week's data, now how are we going to perform this week, to the mindset where we say we have data right now, what are we going to do right now? And so I'm encouraging people to start thinking about that and preparing themselves for how do you deal a little bit more quickly with decisions and how do you automate that stuff. Anyhow, so that's my answer on if you want to start learning data science right now, what's an area you could focus on? That's my opinion and I hope you like it and I hope you start learning a little bit about real-time analytics.